Good evening, dear ladies. Let us bless V'siyata Dishmeh that we will all have the schut to greet Mashiach Tzidkanu B'chamim B'oim B'mrabi Aminu Amen Eliyahu Anavi Eliyahu Tishbi Eliyahu Gledi B'mrabi Avolenu Im Mashiach Ben David Eliyahu Anavi Zachor L'tov. May we all have the schut to see Beit HaMikdash HaShlishi B'mrabi Aminu Amen K'ayin B'ayin L'shub Nei Tzion Atat Akum Terachem Tzion Ki Et Lecha Nena Kiva Moed Hashivenu Adonai Elecha V'nashuv Achadesh Yameinu Kekedem. And we all have the schut to go to Eretz Yisrael on the wings of eagle. And B'siyata Dishmeh, we all have the schut to be part, to have part in Eretz Yisrael. Dear ladies, I would like to say that this shiur, we are just in front of the beginning of Chodesh Nisan, between the month of Adar and the month of Nisan. And I would like to say that the shiur is Leilui Nishmat Rabbi Chaim Yosef Ben David Barachel Alav Shalom Tishum Totzorah Betzorah Chaim Leilui Nishmat El Chananel Mordechai Ben Rachel Alav Shalom Tishum Totzorah Betzorah Chaim Leilui Nishmat David Ben Ephraim Alav Shalom Tishum Totzorah Betzorah Chaim Leilui Nishmat Yehudit Pearl Bat Orit Alav Shalom Tishum Totzorah Betzorah Chaim ובסייעתא דשמיא לעילוי נשמת מלכה בת אברהם, עליה השלום תהי נשמתה לצורה בצור החיים. And all of the souls that don't have anybody to say for them קדיש, בסייעתא דשמיא, well, מהשם, make them זוכר with us, בעזרת השם, ברכם תארם רחמי צדקתך תמיד גם להם. And בסייעתא דשמיא, for health, mentally and physically, for כלל ישראל, and the whole world, בעזרת השם, מהשם bring שלום upon us, כלל ישראל, the whole world. Dear ladies, this Shabbat we are finishing Chumash Shemot. It's the two parashiyot, Vahikal v'Pikudei b'Siyata Dishmaya, and this is also Parashat Shabbat HaChodesh. You remember we said we have special Shabbatot before the month of Adar and during the month of Adar and before Pesach Be'ezrat Hashem. So we had Shabbat Shkalim. We had Shabbat Zachor before Purim. Shabbat Shkalim was before before the first day of the month of Adar, and then B'siyata Dishmaya we had Shabbat Para last week, and now we have Shabbat HaChodesh before B'siyata Dishmaya, Rosh Chodesh Nisan. And Shabbat HaChodesh speaks about B'siyata Dishmaya, about the month of Nisan. HaChodesh Hazeh Lachem Rosh Chodeshim. This is the first month for you, for the children of Israel. So by the Torah, the month of Nisan is the first month. By our sages, the month of Tishrei is the first month. So first I want to tell you that they are going to take two books of Torah out in the Shul Be'ezrat Hashem on Shabbat, one for the portion of the week, the two portions that we are reading, Vayikal V'Pikudei, and we are finishing Chazak Chazak V'Nit Chazek, we are finishing Chumash Shmot. Next week we are starting Chumash Vayikra B'siyat, Shavu Lenu B'tovah B'siyat HaDishmaya. And we're going to take another book, B'siyat HaDishmaya, to read from Parashat Bo, HaChodesh Hazeh Lachem, Rosh Chodeshim Rishon Ulachem L'Chodshei HaShana. This is the first month of the months of the year, B'ezrat Hashem. So it says in Masechet Rosh Hashanah, we're going to speak about all the customs of the month of Nisan. So it says in Masechet Rosh Hashanah, page 11, Machloket ben Rabbi Eliezer v'Rabbi Yoshua. Rabbi Eliezer says that Tishrei on Tishrei, the month of Tishrei, Nivra Olam, the world was created. V'Rabbi Yoshua says on the month of Nisan, Nivra Olam. And the Tosafot says in the name of Rabbeinu Tam, which was the grandchild of Rashi, Zchutam Tegen Aleinu, he says, באמת, אלו ואלו דברי אלוקים חיים. That this and this is true. This is a speech of life. בניסן עלה במחשבה ובתשרי נבנה, which means Hashem thought of creating the world on the he was thinking about it on the month of Nisan, but on the month of Tishrei, on the 25th of the month of Elul, the creation started, and the human being was created on the first day of the month of Tishrei, which is the big judgment day. So B'siyata Dishmaya, it's very weird. So why would Hashem make the month of Nisan the first month of the year? Because that wealth months in the year, and the Oraita and the Torah starts from the month of Nisan. Why would it be? Because the creation started on the month, on the 25th of the month of Elul, the human being, humanity, was created on the first day of the month of Tishrei. And Besiyata Dishmaya, on the month of Nissan, the children of Israel, Besiyata Dishmaya, was taken out of Egypt. There was Exodus. The redemption of the children of Israel was Bezrat Hashem on the month of Nissan. So from here we understand that Hashem shows us that the redemption of the children of Israel, the Tomeret Yetziat Mitzrayim of the children of Israel on the month of Nissan, is bigger than the creation. Why? Because it's written like this. Bereshit bara Elokim et ha-shamayim ve-et ha-aretz. We'll speak about this sentence in a minute, Bezrat Hashem. In the beginning, Hashem created heaven and earth. And it says, Rashi says, כמו שדרשו רבותינו זיכרונם לברכה, for whom did Hashem created the world? בשביל התורה, for the Torah, and which is called Reshit, the beginning, Reshit Darko, the beginning of his way. This is from Mishlei chapter 8, verse 22. And ובשביל ישראל, and also for the children of Israel, שנקראו Reshit Vuata, that are called the first harvest, of Hashem. And this is from Yirmiyahu, the prophet Yirmiyahu, chapter 2, verse 3, which means that Hashem created heaven and earth and said, let there be light. Hashem, all of this in order that the children of Israel, that is called Reshit Vuata, the first harvest of Hashem, and the Torah, which is called Reshit Darko, the beginning of his way, that the children of Israel, both of them are called Reshit, the beginning, that they will study the Torah, and by this they will be an existence to the world. If Chas v'Shalom, the children of Israel, will stop studying Torah, stop keeping Shabbat, Chas v'Shalom, the whole world goes back to chaos. Because we are the firstborns of Hashem in Chumash Shmot, in Parashat Shmot, in the portion of Shmot, Hashem says to Moshe, tell Paro, that this is Bechori, Bni Bechori Israel. This is my firstborn, the children of Israel. And they have the responsibility of making this world exist by studying the Torah, by following the 620 commandments, 613 the Oraita from the Torah, and 7 commandments from our sages, together 620 Keter, like the number of Keter B'Siyata Dishmaya, and Keter is a crown, Chaf is 20, Taf is 400, Resh is 200, together it's 620, they are the crown of Hashem. So Hashem says, for this I created the world. So B'Siyata Dishmaya, we see that, and we understand now that the first month, Nisan, Hashem put it higher than the month of Tishrei. Why? Because the salvation of the children of Israel was on the month of Nisan. So now let's see what's so important in the month of Nisan. Not only that we were taken out of Egypt and received the Torah after 50 days on Ma'amad al-Sinai, on the mountain of Sinai, which Hashem then connected heaven and earth through giving us the Torah, which means bringing the light of the Torah to this world. B'siyata Dishmaya, we are going to learn about it. So, ha-chodesh hazeh lachem, rosh chodashim rishon hu lachem, lechodshei ha-shana. So we'll have a glance at this sentence, and this is from Parashat Bo. And it says that this month, the month of Nisan, is the first month of the year, and this is the first month of all of the months. The first month of the year, and then it's the first month of all of the months in the year. So look, please, it's written, HaChodesh Hazeh Lachem, this month is to you, but HaChodesh Hazeh Lachem, the end letters, Shin, the end letter of Hazeh, this is Hey, Velachem, to you, is Mem. Shin, Hey, Bemem, is Moshe Rabbeinu, is Moshe. And when we take HaChodesh Hazeh Lachem, Rosh Chodashim, we take the first letters of each word, that this month is the head of all of the months, we can see B'Siyata Dishmaya, that the first letters, the Hey, and another Hey, and the Lamed, and the Resh, and the Chet, Hey, Hey, Lamed, Resh, Chet, hey is 5, another hey is 5, lamed is 30, resh is 200, chet is 8, together it's ramach. It's the 248 mitzvot commandments that we have to follow. This is the commandments that we have to follow, and after we received the first commandment, it included all of the 248 commandments that we must do b'siyata d'shmaya. So the month of Nisan, Be'ezrat Hashem, its in numerical value, Nun is 10, Yud and Nun is 50, Yud is 10, Samech is 60, and Nun is 50, together it's 170. Which means it's 17 multiplied by 10. Yud Pe'amim, 10 times, the name of Hashem, of knowing. Knowing Hashem, Shem Adat, Bereshit Bara Elokim Et HaShamayim Ve'et HaRetz. The initials, Et HaShamayim Ve'et HaRetz, in the beginning Hashem created heaven and earth. Et HaShamayim, heaven and earth. The initials of each word gives us the name of Hashem, of knowing Hashem. Aleph is 1, He is 5, Vav is 6, and another He is 5, it's 17. 17 multiplied by 10 is Da'at Dekdusha. This month Hashem opened our minds to understand, to feel Hashem. Not only to know there's Hashem, but with our hearts to feel Hashem. This is Da'at Hashem. This is exactly the war of Amalek, that they don't want the children of Israel and the nations to know that there's Hashgacha Pratit, that there's, it's not only that there's God in the world, but He is the one that looks over all of the actions that happen in the world and the actions of each human being. B'siyata d'shmaya. So we see that 17 is the numerical value of Tov, of good. Because Tet is 9, Vav is 6, and Bet is 2, together it's 17. So Nisan is 10 times 17, 10 times good. Zedah dekdusha, which is the name of Hashem, of knowing Hashem. And because the exile the exile in Egypt, and the exiles, all the exiles that followed until today, is Galut Adat, which means the exile of knowing that Hashem is here, Hashem is in us, is around us, Hashem is everything, and everything is Hashem. Because if we would have understood this, we wouldn't follow the ways of the evil inclination. We will listen to Hashem and follow His commandments. And we will know Hashem in everything that we do. But because the Samech Mem blinds our spiritual eyes, then we ignore, but we're not in an intention to ignore Hashem, because we don't really know. So we don't have the knowledge of Hashem. So this, when they went out of Egypt, Hashem opened the knowledge. And Moshe Rabbeinu was the Da'at of Am Yisrael. Moshe Rabbeinu was the tap that through him, each and everyone in the children of Israel knew Hashem in their hearts. They felt Hashem in their hearts. They saw the miracles that happens around them individually and to Klal Yisrael all the time. Not only a big time in the 10 plagues, but also individually, how Hashem blesses them, how Hashem helps them, each and every one of them. And this is true to every human being in the world. Because once you stop the rash, that we are rushing after things in this world, but to stop for a minute and just concentrate on all of the good things that Hashem gave us from the moment we wake up in the morning until we go to sleep, then we can fill a few notebooks with saying thank you to Hashem for everything. So the month of Nisan is the month of knowing Hashem in our hearts, and the month of miracle, because Nisan comes from Nes, from a miracle, and the miracles that happened on the month of Nisan to the children of Israel were above nature. In Purim, we had miracles that happened with nature, but on Nisan, it was above nature. You can see it's at the opening of the ocean, all the 10 plagues, everything that happened to the children of Israel, that the Egyptians were buried under the water, they were drowned with the water. Everything that they saw, it's above nature. Everything that they saw the divine presence. Even the maid saw what the prophet Yechezkel didn't see. They saw the divine presence in everything. So let's start Besiyata Dishmaya. We see, we said that Nissan in numerical value is 170. Be'ezrat Hashem, 170 equals makel, a stick. You remember Yaakov Avinu said, "Be'makli avarti et ha'Yarden," with my stick, I went over the Jordan River, because Eliphaz came and took everything that he had. So what is a stick? It says, "Be'nissan nigalu ve'Yisrael ve'nissan atidin ligael," that on the month of Nissan, the children of Israel were redeemed, and on the month of Nisan, the children of Israel are going to be redeemed, which we have the opportunity now if we follow the way of Hashem and love each other and understand why we come to this world. Besiyata Dishmaya, we can be redeemed now. So look, and with what merit? With the merit of Abraham, Yitzchak, and Yaakov. Because we can see that Abraham, our forefather ends with a mem, and Yitzchak ends with a kuf, and Yaakov Avinu, when he is in a higher level, is called Israel, and Israel ends with a lamed. Mem, kuf, lamed is makel. Makel, mem is 40, kuf is 100, lamed is 30, 170. So in the zchut of our forefathers, on the month of Nisan, we were besiyata dishmaya, we were redeemed from Egypt. Lachen, everything is about knowing Hashem. Bechol drachecha de'ehu, that in all of your ways you will know Hashem. All of your ways. Everything that you do, you remember Hashem. 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. 7 days a week. Shiviti Hashem lenegdi tamid, which means I need to remember Hashem in front of me all of the time. And once we do that, besiyata dishmaya, Hashem protect us not to fall, and to see the right path, and to distinguish between truth and falseness. So, and another thing, the exile of the children of Israel was not only the exile in Egypt, not only it was the exile of knowing Hashem, but it was also the exile of the mouth, the exile of the speech, because they didn't have time to study Torah. Even though the Torah was not received yet, it didn't come to this world yet, but Abraham, Yitzchak, and Yaakov already studied Torah. Shem be'ever had a yeshiva. They taught the Torah. How did they teach the Torah? Because they were connected spiritually to higher levels. How did they do that? By analyzing the way Hashem rules his world. And by analyzing this, Avraham Avinu came to the knowledge that there has to be a God to this world. There has to be a ruler, a spiritual ruler that is above everything that he sees. So from this, he became so close to Hashem that Hashem promised him the land of Israel, and he promised him that the children of Israel will inherit the land of Israel, and they will receive the Torah, Besiyata Dishmaya. And from him will come a great nation that is called the children of Israel, and they will be the firstborn of Hashem. So Besiyata Dishmaya, because they were with an exile of speech, on the month of Nisan we go out of the exile of speech, because Nisan, which is 170, is two times Pe, mouth. Pe is 80, He is 5, together it's 85. 85 multiplied by 2 is 170. And this is Besiyata Dishmaya Paro, parallel to Paro. Paro is Pera. You see, Paro is the combination of two words, Pera, evil mouth, which means slandering, or Lashon Hara, gossiping. This is evil mouth. And Pesach, the Arizal says, has a hidden hay, Pesach, a mouth that speaks, but Sach, Chet is 8, Samech is 60, 68. 68 is life. Chet is 8, Yud is 10, another Yud is 10, Mem is 40, together it's 68, which means a mouth that speaks Torah, holiness, that gives good words, finds the merit of the children of Israel and everyone, B'siyata Dishma, is a mouth of life, that gives life. So we can choose either to have, to be like Pharaoh, Perah, an evil mouth, or we can choose to be Kmo Pesach, Pesach, which means a mouth that gives, that the his speech gives life. By speaking of holiness, by speaking words of Torah, and by giving good words, making tzedakah, charity with our mouth, B'siyata Dishman, finding the merit of the children of Israel and the whole world, B'zat Hashem, of our husbands, our children, ourselves, because if we're not satisfied with ourselves, we can't give a good word. We can't be mefargen to others. We need to first be happy with ourselves. So we see in the month of Nissan that combines the two exiles, the exile of knowing Hashem and the exile of speech. And on the month of Nissan, we are getting out of both of them, B'siyata Dishmaya, in the process of getting out of both of them. Lachen, בכל דרכיך דאהו, with all of your ways you should know him, you should know Hashem, everything you do you should remember Hashem, everything. When you eat, you have a bracha before you eat and the bracha after you eat. When you go to take out your waste, you have a asher yatzar. When you wake up in the morning, you say modeh ani. When you go to sleep, you say kriyat shema. You say shema yisrael b'siyata dishmaya. You put tzedakah. You read the Tehillim in the house. You do a frashat chala in the house b'siyata dishmaya. You kiss the mezuzah. Everything you do is with Hashem. Vechol ma'asecha l'shem shamayim. And everything that you do should be for the sake of heaven, not for your sake to have to be called righteous or to have any pride. But the sake of heaven. And look, we Hashem, the children of Israel are parallel to the moon. And our calendar is by the moon. And why by the moon? Because once we mekadesh achodesh, we sanctify the month, and every Shabbat before the first day of the month, the rabbi in the shul already says that on this day, at this time, the new month begins. So it goes by the mouth of the children of Israel. That's why even Levana, which is the moon, equals in numerical value to Pe. Look how beautiful it is. Lamed is 30, Bet is 2, Nun is 50, and Hey, B'siyata Dishmaya, is 5. Together, it's Pe, B'siyata Dishmaya. So we see that everything is connected. Furthermore, we'll speak about the names now of the month. I'm giving you just notes before we go to the customs of the month of Nissan. So the month of Nissan has three names. One is the month of Nissan, and you should know that this name of Nissan comes from Babylon, when they came back from Babylon, and it's mentioned twice in all the Tanakh. One in Megillat Esther, chapter 3, verse 7, and the other one in the prophet Nehemiah, chapter 2, verse 1. So both of them, twice the name of Nissan is mentioned. Furthermore, the name of Nissan is also, this month is also called the month of spring, of the Aviv. Why? Because it's the head of all the 12 months, Aviv. Aviv means Av. You see, Aleph Bet is Av, the father of Yud Bet. Yud is 10, Bet is 2, 12 of the 12 months. Because the Torah says, Hashem says, Achodesh hazeh lachem rosh chodashim. This month will be the head of all the 12 months. So it's called also Aviv. It's the head of the 12 months. Beautiful. And then B'siyata Dishmaya, it's called Rosh Chodashim, the head of the months. But look, Kisser HaChamim says a beautiful thing about it. And I wrote it for you over here. So Kisser HaChamim said, look, it's HaChodesh HaZeh Lachem Rosh Chodashim. It's the head of all of the months. If you look at the word Chodashim, the months, in the word Chodashim, there's the word of Mashiach. You see Mem, Shin, Yud, and Chet, and the letter Daled. You see? Mashiach and Dalid. So let's look at it. And it says, he says that Mashiach, it gives all of the four names of Mashiach. The Mem is parallel to Menachem. The Shin is parallel to Shiloh. And Yud is parallel to Inon. And Chet is Hanina. Besiyata Dishmaya, from Kiseh Rachamim, he writes like this. Chodashim otiyot Mashiach vedaled. שנחלקו רבותינו זיכרונה לברכה that our sages had a discussion בגמרא במסכת סנהדרין page 98 עמוד בית על שמו של משיח on the name of משיח רבי ינאי אומר רבי ינאי says that his name is ינון שנאמר לפני שמש ינון it says in Tehillim that before the sun ינון and then רבי שילה says that his name is שילה Why? Because it's written in Parashat Vayechi, Ad ki yavo Shiloh. And then he says, Rabbi Hanina says, that his name is Hanina, שנאמר, אשר לא אתן לכם חנינה. ויש אומרים מנחם, that his name is מנחם, שנאמר, כי רחק ממנו מנחם. So the Mashiach has, by them, four names. And the four names is combined to the name Mashiach, and they're all hidden in the word Chodashim. And Dalet. Why Dalet? Because it's four names. Menachem, Shiloh, Inon, Vechanina. Furthermore, Besiyata Dishmaya, HaChodesh Hazeh Lachem, we can see Hazeh, which is this month is for you. Hazeh is a numerical value. Tov, He is five. Another He is five. And Zayin is seven. It's Tov, just like we said, the numerical value of the word Tov, which is this is a good month for you. But if you take the numerical value of HaChodesh Hazeh Lachem, HaChodesh is 317, Hazeh is 17, VeLachem is 90. Together, it's 424, which is Kedat. And Kedat, Nashim Yekarot, is the word that is going to be written on the forehead of Mashiach. And Mashiach Ben Yosef in numerical value equals Kedat. And everybody that will look at Mashiach will remember all of his studies in Torah because of Kedat. Why? Because Chaf is for the crown. It's part. You remember that the counts of the Kabbalah are divided to three lines. There's the right line, the left line, and the middle line. And the middle line is the line of the peace. So the middle line contains the Keter, which is the crown. And then the Dalet is Da'at, that combines wisdom and understanding. This is that Chokhmah Bina Vedat. So it's the middle line, and then we have Tavzeh Tiferet. Tiferet is the Torah, which is it's parallel to Yaakov Avinu, Israel, Besiyata Dishmaya. So the Chaf, dear ladies, over here, the Chaf is Keter, the Dalet is that, and the Tav is Tiferet, combines everything, and if we take. And if we add the word to it, 424, and we'll add the word Kedat, together it's 425, which is the letter Chaf, the letter He, and the letter Taf. Instead of Dalet, it will become He. Chaf, He, Vetaf, which is one of part of the 72 names of Hashem. And this name is the name that killed the Egyptian. When Moshe Rabbeinu was looking from the beginning of the world to the end of the world to see if one of his descendants will be good before he killed him with the name of Hashem, one of the names of the 72 names of Hashem, which is this the name. That's why when a Mashiach will come, by the smell of the soul, he will eliminate the ones that Amalek and Erev Arab Bekirbenu, Besiyata Dishmaya, and will give livelihood and remembrance. They will remember the Torah, all of the others, Bezat Hashem, the ones that will have Zchut, Besiyata Dishmaya. Furthermore, Besiyata Dishmaya, it's written in Yeshayahu, the prophet Yeshayahu, chapter 44, verse 13. It's written, like the glory of a man in his home. And Bechokhmai Bane Bait, that is written in Mishlei, that in wisdom a home will be built. So, בליקוטי מוהר"ן, רבי נחמן ברסלב, זכותו תגן עלינו, says that Aviv, that the month of the spring, which is the month of Nissan, is Aleph בתוך בית, Av Yud Bet Chodashim, the father of 12 months, but it means that it's Aleph inside Bet and Yud inside Bet, which means that it's Aleph inside the house, Ki Bet is Bayit, and Yud inside the house. What
the
does
house?
It mean
Aleph
that
inside?
That a person makes all of his organs and all of his veins, all of him, a place for the divine presence to be in. Once he makes it and follows the commandments of Hashem, it's written in Parashat Truma, Vasuli Mikdash Veshachanti Betocham, which means that Hashem says, you will make yourself like a holy place that the divine presence can be, B'siyata Lishma. So B'siyata Lishmaya, we make ourselves a Mishkan to Hashem. That, which means that we make all of our body ourselves, because the body is the clothing of the soul. So the soul will be glowing with the light of Hashem because we purified ourselves and the body. And Besiyata Dishma, this means Aleph betoch Bet. This means that letter Aleph inside Bayit, inside the house, which is us. And then there's Yud inside Bayit, which inside us. What is Yud? The Zohar Kadosh says in Tikkuni HaSoros, it says Yud Chochma, which means the Yud is wisdom. So we need Besiyata Dishmaya, all of our thoughts, everything that we think, just like we said, Bechol Derechecha De'ehu, all of our thoughts should be around Hashem. That everything that we do in the sake of heaven, once we do it in the sake of heaven and it's all around Hashem, then Besiyata Dishmaya, we connect ourselves to Hashem. And once we are connected to Hashem, also all of our actions will be in the sake of heaven. And everything that we will do in Simcha. And Bezrat Hashem will take away the depression and the sadness, because we'll understand that everything comes from Hashem. And by doing this, we are fulfilling Vasuli Mishkan Veshachanti Betocham. That we are becoming the Mishkan of Hashem, each and every one of us. And it starts with us individually, and then our home becomes a Mishkan for Hashem. Mamash Mishkan Me'at, Mikdash Me'at Nesaev, each one of our homes, Bezrat Hashem. And then it goes to the biggest circle, which is Klal Yisrael, and then the whole world, B'siyata Dishmaya. That the whole world, B'siyata Dishmaya, becomes a place that Hashem can bestow His divine presence upon all of us. So this is the month of Nisan. I will give you another thing. Kisera Chamim says B'siyata Dishmaya, he says like this, Rabbi Melamed Rachamim Melamed HaKohen, he says that what is the difference between Moshe and Mashiach? Because Ma Shehaya Hu Shiyeh, and Moshe is a king of the children of Israel, and he is Mashiach, and they are both Be'ibu, they are both coming together. So Moshe Rabbeinu in numerical value, Mem is 40, Shin is 300, and He is 5. It's 345, and Mashiach, Mem is 40, Shin is 300, Yud is 10, and Chet is 8, it's 358. The difference between them is 13, Yud Gimel, 13 attributes of Hashem. This is Yud Gimel, Yud is 10, Gimel is 3, 13. 13 is the number Echad, they will be one above the children of Israel. We all will be one with Hashem. One, Aleph, Echad. Aleph is one, Chet is 8, Dalet is 4, it's 13. And this will bring only love upon us, Klal Yisrael, and the whole world. Aleph is Aleph is 1, He is 5, Bet is 2, and another He is 5. Together it's 13. That's the word love, Ahava in Hebrew. So look how beautiful it is. Be'ezrat Hashem she'egi ha'mashir t'ten b'mera b'yameinu amen. So dear ladies, we're going to speak about all of the minhagim of the month of Nisan. And we start that we don't have a sped. We don't have a sped on the month of Nisan. We don't have a sped, we don't say tachanun. The whole month is considered like a high holiday. The whole month, we don't say a sped and not tachanun. And furthermore, I would like to tell you about before the month of Nissan on Kafchet, which is Friday, will be Bezrat Hashem on Kafchet of Nissan of the month of Adar. This coming Friday, we are going to say the Tfilah of the Shalah Kadosh. I'm going to put it on the WhatsApp in Hebrew and in English. This is a special Tfilah. It's written like this: Tfilah zo shechiber Rabbeinu Hashalah Kadosh. This prayer that the Shalah Kadosh wrote, Einat Tfilah leParnasa b'Muvan haMiluli. It's not. It is a prayer for good Parnasa. But it's not in the literally a prayer for Parnasa, like you'll see when you read the bracha. So this is the bracha, and we're going to post it on the WhatsApp, and you say it on the 28th of the month of Adar to open the gates of Parnasa spiritually and physically, in order that Bezrat Hashem we will be thankful to Hashem, we'll have the fear of Hashem, Bezrat Hashem. And the Siyata Dishma will understand that everything that we have in this world is from Hashem, and nothing really truly belongs to us, because everything is loaned for us from Hashem. And when we go out of this world, it goes to the people that are alive in this world, and we don't take anything with us except for nothing physical, except for the Torah that we studied, the commandments that we followed, and the good deeds that we did, and all of the tzedakah that we did. This is one. Second thing, b'siyata d'ishmaya. So we said we don't have tachanun, we don't fast on the month of Nissan, and we don't do a sped on the month of Nissan. I am reminding you, b'siyata d'ishmaya, that we have a birkat ha'ilanot, the blessing of the trees that we give on the month of Nissan, birkat ha'ilanot. And it says that upon seeing a fruit tree in bloom, b'siyata d'ishmaya, we recite the bracha. We need to, and I'm going to give you the halachot. Kol hayotze b'imei Nisan v'roi ilanot shemotzi'im perot mevarech birkat ha'ilanot. He who said only trees that bear fruits, not trees that don't have fruits, only trees that bear fruits. So when we see the trees blossom, they have the flowers on it, then we say birkat ha'ilanot. Ein mevarchim bracha zo ela pam achat b'shana. We have the chance to say this bracha once a year. And nashim mevarchot birkat ha'ilanot. Women need to say birkat ha'ilanot because she'ein zo mitzvah shazman gerama. So this is a mitzvah that the women also do b'siyata d'ishmaya, and it's right even to take the small children to do it with us in order that they will learn, because this is a mitzvah that comes once a year. V'katan shemegei l'mitzvot b'imei chodesh nisan, nachon shemtin milvarech ad achar shigei l'mitzvot. So if a boy becomes 13 on the month of his Nisan, he should wait until he's 13 and then say the bracha, Bezrat Hashem, the blessing. Velechatchila, we say the bracha on the ones that mehadrin say it on the first day of the month of Nisan, which is B'siyata d'ishmaya Sunday, next Sunday. So Motzei Shabbos is already Rosh Chodesh. We say Yaaleh V'Yavo. It's the month of Nisan. And the name of the month of Nisan, every time before Rosh Chodesh, Hashem gives me the zchut to give you the right combination of the name of Hashem for the month for that month. And B'siyata d'ishmaya, we mechaven, we visualize it on Tfilat Shmona Esrei of Musaf of Rosh Chodesh. We have one day of Rosh Chodesh, which is Sunday. So b'shacharit musaf shel Rosh Chodesh, when we say Baruch Ata Hashem Mekadesh Yisrael v'Rashei Chadashim, blessed are you Hashem that sanctifies the children of Israel on the first days of the month, when we say Baruch Ata Hashem, we mechaven exactly how the combination that is written in the Siddur Yud Kei Vav Kei, and Heyeh Asher Heyeh, the letter Aleph, the letter Hey, and the letter Yud and the letter Hey for the name of repentance of the name of Hashem, Shema Tshuva Shel Hashem, because it's exactly like it's written in the Siddur. So we just need to see it when we say Baruch Ata Hashem. Visualize in your mind the letters. You can look at the Siddur just to see it, and we open the gates of prosperity to us to our children, to our family, to Klal Yisrael, to the whole world, Bezrat Hashem. And furthermore, B'siyata Dishmaya, we need to say the bracha next to two trees that have fruit. It says that it's better to say the bracha outside the city, to find in a pardes, in an orchard, to find two trees that have fruits. It's better when they have different fruits. But it's okay that when they have the same fruits, it has to be two trees with fruits, and then to say the bracha. There's a minhag that people say it with 10 people together, they say it, but it's okay to say it as soon as possible. So even if you're alone and you see two trees of fruits and you see them blossoming before they become fruits, you need to say the bracha when they start blossoming. So then you say the bracha. It's one time and it's a big fixing. And there's a whole bracha that you say, B'siyata Dishmaya, and a whole, and Yehi Ratzon Bezrat Hashem. And there's also the blessings, Reach Bni, when Yitzchak Avinu said that he's going to bless Esav, and Yaakov came and he went in to receive the blessing from his father Yitzchak. And he says, Reach Bni, Kereach Sadeh Asher Berchu Hashem, that I see that the smell of my son is like the fragments of the field that Hashem blessed, because this is the field of Gan Eden. There's Gan Eden in this world and there's Gan Eden in heaven. And Bezrat Hashem, when Mashiach is here, Hashem is going to reveal the paradise that is in this world and the hell that is in this world, because there's a paradise in heaven and also hell in heaven. So Hashem is going to reveal everything when Mashiach is here. B'mera b'yameinu, amen. And I would like to remind you, Bezrat Hashem, that we also, there's another minhag that we do. We read Parashat Neso three times. We use it once when the parasha comes, and it's in Chumash Bamidbar. Once when the parasha comes, by the order of the portions of the week, when it comes in Chumash Bamidbar, we read it on Shabbat in the shul. But then we read it also on Chanukah. You remember we read Parashat Neso is the portion of the leaders of the tribes, the Nesi'im, on the first day of the month of Nisan, there was the celebration of the Holy Tent. And the B'siyata Dishmaya, all of the leaders, all of the Nesi'im, the presidents of each tribe, came with a gift to the Mishkan, because it was a celebration of the Mishkan, Chanukat HaBayit, B'siyata Dishmaya, Chanukat HaMishkan. And we read on Chanukah, each and every one of them, every day of Chanukah. And on the 8th, they read from the 8th until the end. So now, B'siyata Dishmaya, we read from the first day of the month of Nisan, which is this coming Sunday. We read until the 14th of the month of Nisan, because at the night of the 14th, it's already Pesach. We're going to speak about Pesach and all of the Jewish laws and the halachot of Pesach, Blezrat Hashem. But we read every day parallel to every president, every nasi of each tribe. So on Sunday, B'siyata Dishmaya, we start with the first presidents, and we'll write you everything, and we'll make you a picture of all of this, B'siyata Dishmaya. The first president is Vayiha Makriv B'yom HaRishon Et Korbano Nachshon Ben Aminadav L'Mate Yehuda. It's the president of the tribe of Yehuda, Nachshon Ben Aminadav. So the first day is for the first day of the month of Nisan. So from here we start reading. It's in Chumash Bamidbar, chapter 7, B'siyata Dishmaya, verse 12. So this is how we start. The second day, we read Bayom HaSheni. So Monday, we read the second day. Each day, its portion. Dear ladies, this is parallel, because Nisan is Av Yud Bet Chodeshim, is the head, the father of all of the 12 months. So we have the zchut, the merit, to bless all of the coming months through the month, B'siyata Dishmaya, of Nisan. The first days of Nisan. So it's a big zchut, don't miss it. So B'siyata Dishmaya, the first day is parallel to the month of Nisan. So we ask from Hashem, Be'ezrat Hashem, that Hashem will bring the light, His light, to this world and help us do tshuva with mercy, with rachamim. And may Hashem bring Mashiach tzidkenu b'rachamim b'urim b'mara b'yamein amen. We ask from Hashem for Eliyahu Navi Zachur Latov. First we ask for Klal Yisrael and the whole world. And we ask for Hashem, Be'ezrat Hashem, to see the building of the third temple b'mara b'yamein amen. To see the menorah lit in the third temple. To have part to go to the land of Israel on the wings of eagle. To have part in the land of Israel. And we ask from Hashem that Hashem will bring to this world peace and love and stop the plague. B'siyata d'ishmaya. And then, b'nei chayeu mazonei. Ask for everything that you want. On the month of Nissan, there were miracles above nature. You're close to yourself. Everybody knows what they need. If it's parnasa, if it's children, if the children need to be on the right way, Be'ezrat Hashem, always bless them that they will be zera bar kama, d'osher mevorach, that they will be righteous, they will be have the fear of Hashem, the love of Hashem, Be'ezrat Hashem. That they will all be mezakei harabim, which means they will all teach Torah, and then Hashem will give them their zivugim, Be'ezrat Hashem, on time, b'siyata d'ishmaya, and that it will be a binyan ad, a house that we will build forever, b'ezrat Hashem, that will follow the Torah and the commandments, b'ezrat Hashem. You ask from Hashem for parnasa, good income, spiritually and physically, b'ezrat Hashem. You ask matira surim, that we will all be free from the evil inclination, from yetzara. And everybody that needs freedom, b'siyata d'ishmaya, needs, if the chas v'shalom, they have a trial, or they have something that Hashem will free them. And everybody that is addicted, either to money, to women, to alcohol, to drugs, may Hashem, be'ezrat Hashem, take him out of the addiction. And he will be addicted to Hashem. That Hashem will be part of his life, and the light of Hashem will be inside him. So each month is parallel to each day. It's a big thing. The second day, which is next Monday, is for the month of Iyar. And you remember, the Sfirat HaOmer, we count the Omer on the month of Iyar. So each we go out on the month of Iyar from one gate of impurity to a gate of purity. So we ask for Hashem, Be'ezrat Hashem, to take us out of all the gates of impurity that we are in, and to help us to see the truth out of the falseness, and that our mouth will be a mouth of holiness, Be'ezrat Hashem, and always will give good words to each other. This is the big charity that we can do with each other, biggest charity that we can do. And by teaching each other and speaking Torah with each other and speaking emunah, faith, because when a person speaks about emunah, about faith, it's not only he's helping his fellow, he's also helping himself, because what goes out of the heart goes into the heart of our friends, but it also goes back to our heart, because the ears are the microphone of the organs. So we also hear it. So by doing this, we help not only others, but also ourselves to be closer to Hashem. So this is the month of Iyar. And Besiyata Dishman, then the month, and may Hashem, on the month of Iyar, we have Kafchet Beiyar. Kafchet Beiyar is the freedom of Yerushalayim. Yom Yerushalayim, the day of Yerushalayim, that Hashem brought back all the holy places to the children of Israel. May Hashem free Yerushalayim now.
Amen.
Be'ezrat Hashem. And cleanse all of us, Be'ezrat Hashem. And then we come to the third day. The third day is parallel to the month of Sivan. On the month of Sivan, we receive the Torah. May Hashem open our hearts that we will be the vessel of Hashem, of His oral Torah, of His written Torah and His oral Torah. And then we come to the month of Tammuz, which is the fourth day. You remember, because by the Torah, B'siyata d'ishmaya, we count the months from the month of Nisan. So B'siyata d'ishmaya, we come to the month of Tammuz. B'shem Hashem na'aseh v'natzliach enu milvado. Hashem sfatai tiftach ufi yegid tilatecha. The month of Tammuz, we have the Yud Zayin of Tammuz. The 17th of Tammuz. Look, 17th. We just spoke about the month of Nisan. 170. Good. In Hebrew, Tov. 17, B'siyata d'ishmaya. Makel. All of the end letters of Abraham, Yitzchak, v'Yisrael. All of them is Makel. 117. 10 times 17. B'siyata d'ishmaya. We see B'siyata d'ishmaya that this is the name Et HaShamayim V'et HaAretz, heaven and earth. This is the name of knowing Hashem, B'siyata d'ishmaya. 17th means good. That B'siyata, at the end of days, this will be a high holiday. So this is the time when the walls of Jerusalem fell down in the time of Nebuchadnezzar, the first ruining of the temple and the second ruining of the temple. So we ask Hashem to build the temple, to build Beit HaMikdash, that we will be all Zoche. Remember, first we ask for everyone, and then B'siyata Dishmeh, all the individual things that we need for ourselves, our fellow, our friends, our family, everything that Akal always add everyone. Say, Hashem, I'm asking for Zivugim, for Klal Yisrael, Me'alef Ataf. Klal Yisrael, and then mention the names of people that you know. B'siyata Dishmeh, this is the month, the fourth day is parallel to the month of Tammuz. The fifth day is parallel to the month of Av. Dear ladies, the month of Av, B'siyata Dishmaya, the month of Av is the ninth of Av when the temple was ruined, the first and the second temple. We ask from Hashem, Bezat Hashem, that Hashem will be Ahavat Chinam, unconditional love among us, in order that the Beit HaMikdash will be built. We ask from, there's Tu B'Av, the 15th of Av, Bezat Hashem, where the children of Israel got married, all of the tribe that had a permission to get married between the tribes, which is a big day, and there was a peace between the 11th tribes and the tribe of Binyamin. This is a big thing, the 15th of Av. So B'siyata Dishmaya, we ask from Hashem that He will spread His love upon us, His light upon us, that we will be a vessel of Hashem, that all of this false hatred will go away from us, and Hashem, Bezrat Hashem, by the love, will bring Mashiach with mercy to this world. And then we come to the sixth day, which is parallel to the month of Elul, and we ask B'siyata Dishmaya from Hashem on the month of Elul, that Hashem will forgive us and help us to repent over everything that we didn't do in His will, Bezrat Hashem, before the big judgment day, which is Rosh Hashanah, which is on the first day of the month of Tishrei. So B'siyata Dishmaya, this is the month of Elul. And then we come to the month of Tishrei, which is the seventh day, which is Shabbat next week, the seventh day. And the seventh day is parallel to the month of Tishrei. And we ask B'siyata Dishmaya from Hashem, that Hashem will help us to repent with love to Him, Bezrat Hashem. Because we have, on the month of Tishrei, we have Rosh Hashanah, we have Yom HaKippurim. Rosh Hashanah is the judgment day, Yom HaKippurim is the sealing day. And then we have Sukkot B'siyata Dishmaya. May Hashem help us, B'siyata Dishmaya, to be protected by His names, Bezrat Hashem, that is in the word Sukkah, Bezrat Hashem. Protect us, our children, our husbands, Klal Yisrael, the whole world. And then we come to the eighth day, which is parallel to the month of Cheshvan. And the month of Cheshvan is the time where the Mabul started, where the flood started. So B'siyata Dishmaya, may Hashem help us to keep our mouth. And B'zrat Hashem, Hashem help us, the men that they won't have a spreading the sperm in vain, and that we will remember that we are Jews, and Hashem commanded us to marry only Jewish people. That we will remember where we came from, who we are, and where are we going to. And we'll remember that we are His firstborns, Bezrat Hashem. And then we come, B'siyata, and we'll ask from Hashem that all of the rains that come, that should be rains of blessings, B'siyata Dishmaya. And then we come to the ninth day, which is the month of, parallel to the month of Kislev. Kislev is Chanukah. May we see the menorah lit in Beit HaMikdash HaShlishi B'Mara B'Yameinu Amen. When we see the miracles of the Maccabim B'siyata Dishmaya, may the light of Chanukah will come upon us and Klal Yisrael. And then the 10th month is parallel to the month of Tevet. And Tevet, we have the 10th of Tevet that started a siege over Yerushalayim. May Hashem B'siyata Dishmaya will take out all of us out of the siege that we are now, the siege of the evil inclination, and the siege that we put ourselves thinking that our saviors is the nations, but the true savior, the true Moshiach is Hashem Yitbarach Shemo, is HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Then we come to the 11th day. The 11th day is parallel to the month of Shvat. And B'siyata Dishmaya, on the month of Shvat, Bezrat Hashem, we have Tu B'Shvat, the flourishing of all nature, Bezrat Hashem, around us. That Hashem will give us B'siyata Dishmaya like it was in Bereshit, that when we put the seed, the adama, when they put the seed in the ground, immediately a tree grew with all of the fruits on it. So this is how Bezrat Hashem, Hashem will give us the schut Bezrat Hashem. And then we come to the 12th day. The 12th day is parallel to the month of Adar Purim Bezrat Hashem. Mishanichnas Adar Marbin Besicha, that we will always be happy, that we will always be rejoiceful, because we will remember Hashem. Shiviti Hashem Lenegdi Tamid. And by remembering Hashem Bezrat Hashem, we will, Besiata Dishmaya, bring joy to the whole world and love, unconditional love to each other, Bezrat Hashem. And when we love each other, it means that we love Hashem. Because if we love His children, we love Hashem. If we don't like His children, we don't love Hashem, because we are all Hashem's children. So if you love Hashem, if you say that you love God, you need to love His children. And accept them the way they are, and daven for them, and pray for them, that we will all do tshuva in front of Hashem. Us, as the children of Israel, the firstborns of Hashem, and the nations, that they will follow the seven commandments of Noach. And Besiyata Dishmaya, we come, Besiyata Dishmaya, to the 30, to Yud Gimel, to the 13th of the month, of the month of Nissan, and the 13th of the month of Nissan, we read Besiyata Dishmaya. On the 13th of the month of Nissan, we read parallel to Adar Bet, to a leap year, the second Adar, we read Mizot Chanukah Bezrat Hashem, including the first four verses from chapter 8 of Parashat Baalotcha. So we read from Zot Chanukah until the end of the four verses in Parashat Baalotcha. We'll give you, Bezrat Hashem, we'll make a picture and send it to all of you. And this is parallel to the month of Adar Bet Besiyata Dishmaya. And we ask from Hashem, like the Adar Bet doesn't have a constellation, and the children of Israel are above the constellations when they behave as the children of Israel. So Yud Kei Vav Kei is the one that we get the light from, the name of Hashem, Yud Kei Vav Kei, and we are above the constellation. We ask from Hashem, Bezrat Hashem, that it will be deservable, that we will be deservable by knowing Hashem, having the fear of Hashem and the love of Hashem, to be Bezrat Hashem above the constellation. And then Bezrat Hashem, we have miracles that above nature. So dear ladies, this is the 12th, the 12 presidents, and these are all of the things that we need to read until the 13th of the month of Nisan. The 14th of the month of Nisan, we ask for Mashiach, because 14, Yud is 10, Daled is 4, together it's Yad, it's 14. 14 is parallel to David, Mashiach ben David. David, Dalet is 4, another Dalet is 4, Vav is 6, it's 14. So we ask for Mashiach, we ask for Eliyahu Mizrachul Otos, we ask Bezrat Hashem LeBeit HaMikdash, and we go into Besiyata, which is, it will be next 14, it will be next Shabbat, not this coming Shabbat, the next Shabbat, and we ask for Mashiach in 2 weeks, 2.5 weeks. So Besiyata Dishmaya, we ask for Mashiach, and we ask for the building of Beit HaMikdash, and we ask Besiyata Dishmaya to go to the land of Israel on Kanfei Nesharim and have part of the land of Israel. And then Besiyata Dishmaya comes Leil HaSeder. Another thing that we do Besiyata Dishmaya is Kimcha de Pischa, Maot Chitin. We give tzedakah. We usually give it to the Gabbai of Bet Knesset. We give it to people that don't have enough money to do Pesach. Please give tzedakah, Besiyata Dishmaya. If we give tzedakah with a good heart, Besiyata Dishmaya, Hashem will open His hand to us, because it's like a cycle. What we give, Hashem gives us back. We don't give it because we want Hashem to give us back. We give it because we want to be a good messenger of Hashem and to make other people happy, so they will have a seder and they will have enough with all of the with the food and everything that they need for Leil HaSeder. I would like to bench all of us, to bless all of us, that we will all be zochet to greet Mashiach Tzidkenu Barachamim Moim Bimara Bayameinu Amen. And Besiyata Dishmaya, that we will all hear and see Eliyahu Navi Zechu Latov and see the building of Beit HaMikdash HaShishi B'mera B'yameinu Amen L'olam Yipared Adam Mechavor B'dvar Halacha Yachid B'Rabim Halacha K'Rabim and B'Siyata Dishmaya Talinu B'Tov V'Takitzu B'Yishua V'Rachamim.